Howdy, everybody. Old Jay Bird here. Fixed to get back on Timmy's air tube for that cattleman. Air gun, the one that went out of business. But I had a question, and I'm waiting on it. Skinny Mitch to holler at me. Excuse me. Little caffeine going on. But anyways, I was milling around the other day, and then I started figuring out some things, and so I ordered me one of these Firefly Eagle Vision setup doohickey for any scope I have or whatever. It's gonna send, you know, I need more camera equipment. But I got that little dude. And I got all the cases. I bought extra cases because, you know, when you're riding that queenie out back, Daisy, there ain't no telling. You see the shape of my hat the way it is? I call it my crash hat. That's my riding hat. But, yeah, I thought I'd just holler at y'all and look at this little Eagle Vision setup a little bit. Hopefully, like I say, Skinny Mitch get a hold of me. I got a question about the length of the, that's like 1 inch. Sticking out. I don't know about that, but I'll heat it up and break it loose here in a little while. Oh man. Other than that, I hope everybody's been doing good, been doing a little shooting. It's that, almost that time of the year where the invasive species start showing up. English sparrows and starlings. A couple different other blackbirds around. You can't shoot boat-tailed grackles if you didn't know that. Unless your state says you can. But in Texas, they prefer you not to unless they're like crawling all over your car and pooping everywhere. Then they're a menace. But, yeah, I got I bought me some white sheets that I'm gonna put on the wall and everything. Make it a little more, you know, more of a it's a shooting hide, the Texas hide here, but make it a little more so color will stand out. Just some white sheets. Cover up some of this mess. Plus, it'll knock the dust down. Won't get all on my scopes and everything as bad. But, see, I got that. Oh, I got me some of them, they don't catch dogs. It's a piece of pipe and it has a, it's pretty stout. I guess you gotta step on it to set it. And then you set it in the ground on that spike, fill it up with cat food or whatever, and then you take the chain and then you loop the cable around there and you put all that shit together. But they're coon traps. No dog coon traps or something like that. I got a few of them because I've been finding coon tracks in the back toward the southwest back there. And I got Daisy in the backyard right now. She's finally getting a feel better. But anyhow, I bought them, so when I start seeing, instead of them ones about that long traps, probably about that long, about 3 inches, those traps about tracks that are about that long, I don't want them 40 pounders, 30 to 40 pounds. That's too much. Blech. But anyways, then I'll have to get my trapper's license so I can sell the furs. But I was walking around the back and all I seen was big ones and they're heavy. So it's a mom and daddy ordeal. But when them little ones about yay big, 15, 20 pounds come out and about, because I'm only going to catch them, dispatch them, and I'm going to eat them. So it ain't going to do me no good to shoot one of them 40 pounders. So I'll eat the eggs, you know what I'm saying? I ain't going to eat the chicken, I'm going to eat the eggs. Homeless chick. Yep. Them little critters like about, that's less to tell. They're about like that. They're about 10 or 15 pounds. Then you know they got the tail. Them's good eating little dudes. You can put them in a barbecue pit. You can take it all like debone hold out them thing. You can fry it if you wanted to. Which I ain't never tried fried coon. I've eaten on the barbecue pit, baked in the oven. Sort of kind of like steak, rice, and gravy style. In a cast iron skillet. Man, some of that shit brings back a whole lot of memories from way back up there in Corrigan River Bottom. Woo-hoo! And Spurgeon, my grandfather, he always trapped and did all that mess. We'd be out hunting, next thing I know, he's putting a raccoon or two in the back of my squirrel vest. Try carrying about three of them dudes out. That's like, you know, that's 45 pounds. Plus squirrels. But I wouldn't trade it for the world. They always had something. Possums, you know, stuff like that. But I am feeling better on my finger thing. I keep it elevated. I still got these two marks because I was out there, I got some hay to go feed Daisy. And I just scooped in there, got me two of these. It's 100-pound bells, but I got two of the squares. The square's about like this. Anyway, I got two of them. I stuck my hand up in there and was milling around. And I got this, and I walked out the back, and I threw it here and there. You know, I broke it up, make her move. And made that gun, what was it, a couple days ago in the evening? I wasn't paying attention too much, but that's when that old finger swelled up. But I know I poked myself right here, barely, with the O-ring remover. But I got two little holes. A little bit more than an eighth inch apart. Now I know I didn't stick my finger but once when I first started working on Tim's stuff. But I tell you what, that dude's 1 inch thick, 1 inch wide, swollen up, can't hardly do, you know, quacha with it. That's as far as I can bend it. Oh, it hurts. But, I figure if it swells up some more, if it's not gout. I've had gout in my hands before, but not nothing like this. I figure I'll, I got a friend, and she'll come over with diabetic needle. We'll pull the plunger out, and we're gonna stick where I can't really feel up in the front of that knuckle and maybe behind it, and see if we can drain that off. That might be the one. I don't feel like doing that shit tonight. My luck, I'll be bleeding like a stuck hog when I wake up anyways. But, yeah, I just thought I'd check in with y'all, tell y'all about my new little camera for my scope, plus videos out and about if it ain't on my scope. And I got them traps. That's pretty cool. And I got bed sheets. Everywhere is around in here. And the winner's gonna have whatever I did with it. Must be over underneath that old sheet. I'm gonna take some camouflage net. I'm gonna start at the top. I'm gonna have it overlap. Well, I'm gonna have to start at the bottom, tell you that. Staple it. I figure about three or four pieces on that 6 foot window right there. And then I can still see you out, but they can't see in. So that'd be pretty cool. Oh yeah, I hadn't even messed with any other air guns. Other than this air tube at one time. Of course, I just got through getting over being sick. Yeah, I got a, since that stroke back in 2012, I'm susceptible to every other kind of stroke there is. If it's heat stroke, if I get too hot, then I'm going to dehydrate. If I don't watch my intake of fluids, certain kinds of fluids, like milk, soy milk, or almond chocolate milk, stuff like that, and keep a check on my blood pressure, then you can do the pinch test, see it went down. You'll dehydrate. And whatever other kind of strokes are out there, I don't know. I can't think of it offhand. I probably need to go take my medicine anyways. Yeah, I gotta take medicine for the thought process. Well, I got the target there. It's sitting right there below it. And I can't wait to shoot that little hoe. Of course, I was called out on that too. By one person, and his name starts with a T, and I'm working on his air tube. Timmy, you gonna challenge somebody, dog? You need to get your 66-year-old older than dirt butt. I like that part, get older than dirt. Get your, man, you gotta be able to back it up. Well, he sent me a message back, which I found pretty daggum neat. He goes, I'll be lucky to hit a 5 foot diameter circle up against a barn. And I'll probably miss the barn. That's Timmy. But I hope Skinny Mitch get back with me so he can answer me a couple questions. I've never worked on one of these, but I got everything sealed up. And I found another kind of a valve, but it'll raise the tube up about a half an inch. And I don't know if he has the barrel and a half inch tube to move up clearance in for the clearance. But I found one to fit it. And like I say, I got a bunch of parts. But I need to get my butt in gear and get well and get over all everything and just start doing my thing as far as my air guns go. Start shooting out there, I don't know, I think the fence is 45 and then that can back there is another 5 yards, so that's 50 yards. You ain't got no reason, if you can't, you don't have no reason to shoot further than 50 yards. I mean, my credit gator shoots 50 yards, and I'll peg if it don't, if it'll start stacking at 50 yards. And all I'm doing is, with that Immerse optic, is using holdover or, you know, stuff like that. But, them English kill me, but. What are you saying bot for? Bot? But. Anyways, that's about all I got for the moment, top of my head. But I got night vision equipment and all that. And I got that heck of a light. There it is. It's down there. That headlight I always messing with. Rechargeable. I shine out there and crank it all the way up and shine the cans at 50 yards and just put the scope on it. But I'm going to use the headlights and stuff when I shoot in the evening with the Eagle Vision and the Firefly setup. So y'all can actually see, you know, hopefully we can see some pellets if we can slow it down a little bit. I don't have an app on my phone, which I need to do some more research. Getting a good app that I can slow it down and you can watch the pellet hit the target or the slug. Yeah, I'm sort of kind of in between on slugging, means I shoot less than 50 yards and less, versus shooting a slug, which don't get me wrong, there ain't nothing wrong with anybody just shooting slugs. But, a pellet is pretty much from here to 50. Hell, I shoot a squirrel off that fence here a while back. I was at 45 yards. I shot two across the street. One was at 45 and one was at 50-ish. I mean, it was close when I ranged it. Man, 49.8 yards or something. Sender punched him in the head. I mean, that's the kill zone. Of course, that first one took me about 5 shots to figure my dope for my holdover. And once I got it, it was over with. Look at him. Y'all be careful. And like Dead Lead Air says, keep your air dry. And stay charged up. It's the only time I can shoot. I don't shake. I don't know what to do with it. I think something to do with caffeine. But anyhow, y'all take care until next time I see you. Maybe I'll have all this messed all together and we'll go out there and set the coon trap. We'll put one out and just see. And then Daisy's eyeballing me. That going, girl. Where's my feed? My feed. So So I'm gonna go back out there to either a spider or a snake pile of hay. I said, I need to drain that. Just stick that little needle in there and get it over with. Might be gout, but normally gout gets me in both fingers, so I don't know.
No.
But y'all be safe. Keep that air dry. And always make sure of your backstops. Remember them old wooden fences around there? No. If your air gun's a FAC and you got it tuned at 20 plus feet, it's gonna go through that wood on that fence. That ain't worth the flip. But other than that, y'all in my good eye? All right, y'all take care.